Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Vaping, the use of e-cigarettes. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, vaping has been linked to more than 40 deaths across the United States. Joining us to talk about vaping is Dr. Ni-Cheng Liang, who is a pulmonologist, a lung doctor at Scripps Memorial Hospital in Encinitas, California. Thanks so much for being with us.
Happy to be here, Susan.
Let's start off with the basics. What is vaping?
So vaping is when someone chooses to use a device that basically heats a liquid into a vapor. It is usually contained in the form of liquid in a cartridge, usually this big, but there are many, many different varying sizes now. When a person inhales, there's a sensor that triggers a heating element within this device to heat that liquid, which then transforms that liquid into a smoke that the person then inhales.
So what ingredients are contained in these e-cigarettes?
So the e-cigarette contains many different compounds, including marijuana derivatives such as THC and CBD, as well as nicotine, and a whole host of different flavorings that are available now marketed towards children.
When you talk about the marijuana products, what is CBD?
So CBD is a chemical that's found in the marijuana plant that does not give the person that's using CBD the typical high from THC.
But it does help with pain, does it not?
Yes, CBD oil can be used topically and also ingested to help with pain and to help with sleep and induce relaxation.
And then THC, that can also be in the e-cigarette, but that's the part that gets you high?
Yes, Susan.
Can you vape without having the THC?
Absolutely, you can vape without having the THC or the CBD or the nicotine or the flavoring.
So why has vaping become so popular?
I think that with the bad press that smoking gets in general, vaping was initially thought to be a possible way for people to stop smoking. But it has turned into somewhat of a fad, a novelty for our youth, adolescents, high schoolers. And in fact, the e-cigarette user age is much younger than that of smokers. So I think there's a novelty component to it. And also the flavorings, unfortunately, attract a much younger user population.
What kind of flavorings are you talking about?
For instance, raspberry, candy flavors, even menthol flavors. Things that are the same flavorings in candy in general.
But then, I mean, you just referenced it, but e-cigarettes, weren't they originally seen as the healthier alternative to smoking, that people could actually wean themselves off of cigarettes with this vaping?
So initially that was the thought and the hope, but technically the FDA has never approved vaping or e-cigarettes as a modality to quit smoking. And the literature actually suggests there's a lot of conflicting results. Some results show that it did help people quit smoking, but a year later, they were then addicted to the e-cigarettes. Other reports show that there is no difference in using e-cigarettes to quit smoking compared to nicotine-containing products in terms of efficacy in quitting smoking.
And e-cigarettes are more popular with women, men?
So in epidemiologic studies, it's about 50%. It's a pretty even split, perhaps slightly increased among male users.
And as far as age is concerned?
Much younger population of users, so 18 to 24-year-olds consist of 40% of the e-cigarette users.
And then another 25% of patients are what, ages 25 to 34, I believe, according to the Centers for Disease Control. And you're saying that it's popular for this younger crowd because of all of the different flavors?
Yes, I do believe so.
Do you think that vaping is safer than smoking?
No, absolutely not. Reason being, vaping contains so many different additives. In the beginning of the advent of the e-cigarette, there were technically less chemicals found in the e-cigarette smoke that users would be inhaling compared to smokers. And so there was a thought that because of that, e-cigarette use was less dangerous than smoking. However, we also found out later on that e-cigarette use can also alter the immune system of the lung in dangerous ways. And now with the advent of these e-cigarette or vaping product associated lung injuries that we've been seeing across the United States, it is absolutely not safer than smoking.
We want you to hold this thought. We're going to come back to it in just a couple of minutes. Is there a safe way to vape, to safely use these products? We'll come back and talk about that in just a couple of minutes. You're talking about these horrific lung injuries, even deaths now, being caused by e-cigarettes. And the news reports are talking about this thing called vitamin E acetate. Can you explain what that is and what that does to the lungs when you vape?
Sure. So vitamin E acetate could be one of the culprit ingredients that is found in the lung lavage samples of patients who have this lung injury that has been thought to be vaping induced. And what vitamin E acetate does is it dilutes out the E liquid. So it is oftentimes found with the THC. So many of the vaping-induced lung injury patients did admit to the use of THC-containing e-cigarette vaping products. And in many of those patients, the vitamin E acetate was found in their lungs.
So it's the vitamin E acetate that comes along with THC. Is there vitamin E acetate that comes with CBD or nicotine?
Yes, so there are still quantities of vitamin E that can be found in any e-cigarette containing devices.
And what are the symptoms that you have a problem with your lungs?
So symptoms can include coughing, shortness of breath, chest pain, and in some patients, we've also seen people coughing up blood.
Can you get vaping products without this additive, without this vitamin E acetate?
Vitamin E acetate has been shown to be found more in the black market e-cartridges and less so in the e-vaping products that are regulated. But trace amounts of vitamin E acetate have still been found in the more considered regulated e-cigarette products too.
Would it still put you at risk though for severe lung injury without this vitamin E acetate?
We don't really know yet, because the different additives in there are known irritants to the lung. And I think we're just beginning the story. I think a lot remains to be seen with regards to further research on other chemicals that could be associated with this type of lung injury.
We use vitamin E all the time though. You know, we use it as vitamin E supplements. It's found in food, it's found in cosmetic products. Why does it not cause a problem when we actually ingest it in the food or cosmetics or as a dietary supplement, but it causes, you know, such incredible harm when we ingest it in terms of e-cigarettes?
I think the main reason for this is because the lining of the lung is very different than the lining of our gut and also our skin barrier. The lining of our lung sees the vitamin E acetate as honey coating the airways and the air sacs. So you can imagine if we took honey and put it in someone's lungs, that wouldn't be an ideal situation for breathing.
And when somebody comes in with that kind of a lung injury, is it reversible? Can the lung heal?
So it's partially reversible, and steroids are the mainstay of treatment. But we don't even know what vitamin E acetate does to the lungs. This has never come up before. What we think it might do is it causes a severe and rapid airway obstruction, and it can also induce lung injury from damaging the air sacs within the lungs themselves.
So people that you've treated for this, are they gasping for breath?
I've treated people who have almost died from this type of lung injury, Susan. It's been a huge wake-up call for them, and currently they're doing much better, but it takes a lot of time and completely quitting e-cigarettes and vaping altogether.
And when they have these episodes, can they breathe on their own, or do you have to hook them up to a machine to keep them to breathe for them?
So it depends. My patient actually needed to have a breathing tube stuck down his throat and be connected to life support to help him breathe. Other cases that I've seen, these patients were able to take steroids orally and they got better.
And there are other ingredients in e-cigarettes that also might contribute to these lung issues, right? Because there's been all these news stories about, what is it, pesticides found in the vaping products and actually cyanide? I mean, a deadly poison.
Yes, Susan. Unfortunately, in a lot of the black market products, there have been traces of pesticides that have been found. And when this type of pesticide is heated, it can form hydrogen cyanide.
And these counterfeit products, I mean, they mimic what looks like, you know, a bona fide e-cigarette, right? Because the industry is not regulated. So how do you know you're getting something that's pure as opposed to something that's counterfeit?
Right, you really don't know, unfortunately.
What if you get rid of the flavors? Because you say that these vaping products come in, you know, all kinds of sweet flavors to entice people to use the e-cigarette. What if you got rid of, you know, the flavors in the vaping product? Would that make it safer?
No, unfortunately, because it's so unregulated, what goes into these liquids, we can't control. And even the usual substances of propylene glycol and glycerin, which are considered to be relatively benign, are also known lung irritants as well.
So you're a lung doctor. I suspect you treat people who have, you know, issues with regard to smoking cigarettes. If somebody comes to you and says, look, I want to stop smoking, I want to wean myself off using an e-cigarette, what advice would you give to them?
I would say to please consider some of the more recommended ways of smoking cessation, such as nicotine replacement products, which include lozenges that are hard sucker candies that we can put in our mouth and suck on. We can also use nicotine gum as well as nicotine patches and different pills that can also decrease our cravings for nicotine from smoking.
So we referenced this a couple of minutes ago. Let's come back to this now. Is there a way to vape safely, to safely use these products?
No.
The bottom line is just absolutely no.
The bottom line is absolutely no. And if someone still chooses to continue to vape and to use e-cigarette products, I highly recommend that the source be a reliable one if they're still choosing to continue to purchase and use these products. So not from the black market, not homemade, and not made by friends, and certainly not illegally purchased.
Any final thoughts, Doctor?
Absolutely, Susan. So if you're interested in quitting smoking, please speak to your physician about all of the well-documented ways that are safe to quit smoking, including nicotine replacement products that I already mentioned, as well as pills. But really, Susan, the bottom line is it's not worth your lung health or your life to vape or even try e-cigarettes. The only things you need to inhale are clean air and prescribed inhalers should you need them. That's it. Very simple recommendation.
Dr. Liang, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me.
If you want more information about vaping, please click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? We take care of you from head to toe. Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks so much for joining us. It's our mission at Scripps to help you heal, enhance, even save your life.